Every virus mutates, and SARS-CoV-2 is no exception. Here to discuss the evolution of viruses and what we can do to protect ourselves from the COVID-19 variants we're hearing so much about are two leading experts on the topic, UT Southwestern's Dr. David Greenberg and Dr. Vineet Menachery of the University of Texas Medical Branch at Galveston. Thank you both for joining us. Dr. Greenberg, thank you for joining us. Tell us what a COVID-19 variant is and what the concern is.
Viruses, particularly RNA viruses, which we're talking about today, when they divide and they evolve, they make mistakes or typos in their genetic code. And that's totally normal and expected. And we see that with other viruses such as influenza. Actually, that's one of the reasons that we get a yearly vaccine for influenza, because the virus is constantly changing. And the same holds true for the virus that causes COVID-19 and what we call a variant, or just some of these genetic changes that happen over time in the virus. And sometimes those changes do impact how the virus is either transmitted or makes us ill in the community. And the variants that we've been seeing lately are ones that fall into that category and raise many of the questions that we're all concerned about, which is, what does it mean to have some of these variants circulating in the community, and what are the implications of those?
Dr. Menachery, are these variants known to cause more severe disease, or are they just a manifestation of being more infectious? What's the concern about having a variant as opposed to the first wave of coronavirus infections that we saw?
We'll have a better idea in the next couple of weeks if this virus causes more severe disease, but we're probably looking at something that's a little bit more infectious or a little bit easier to transmit. And there could be a number of reasons for that. The virus may be able to bind better to cells or enter more efficiently. And those are things that give it a small advantage over the original virus. And so over time, as more and more people have been infected, these small differences in the population become bigger differences. And so that small lead that these viruses have in one person, as you multiply that over hundreds of people, those variants become more dominant and we see more of them arise.
Is there any evidence, Dr. Menachery, that these variants are leading to more reinfections, people getting COVID again?
There is some evidence for reinfection, but those are very rare conditions, and that these conditions are often associated with the person that gets infected may have a diminished immune response or some other aspect that may have affected them the first time they had the infection. For the vast majority of people, these variants aren't more likely, but again, we still don't have full answers on that question.
We're hearing about COVID-19 variants from the UK and from other countries. How many different variants are we seeing right now, and are there differences between them?
There are actually thousands of variants that have already been documented. The UK variant that has been in the news a lot has been in the news partly because of how rapidly it has been detected in the UK, and then this worry that that could indicate that this particular variant, for example, is more easily transmissible from person to person. They have a very robust sequencing effort where they monitor the viruses and sequence the full genomes of the viruses. And this is how this was picked up in October or so. And then it was quickly recognized that that was becoming a predominant flavor of this virus that was spreading among the community and now has been seen around the world, including in Texas and a case in Dallas. And so the issue with this particular variant and some others that have been found, including one in Brazil and one in South Africa, the worry about all of them is whether this means we're about to enter a phase where this virus could transmit even more easily than it already is.
Dr. Menachery, in Galveston and here in Dallas, we're pretty early in the vaccine rollout, and many people are concerned that they're getting a vaccine and it may not protect them against the variant.
The vaccines are designed to target our immune system to generate antibodies against multiple spots in the spike protein of the virus. And so it's not that there's one key spot that has to be protected against. Our immune system generates immune responses against the entire spike protein. And so one change isn't going to change the efficacy of the virus. You'd have to have multiple changes. And that's one of the concerns about the UK variant and some of these, is that they do have multiple changes. Even so, the data so far has argued that these vaccines are already protecting against these viruses. And while there's a diminishment of how well they protect in terms of the overall quantity, there's still plenty of protection driven by that.
Dr. Greenberg, the variants in the UK were found by this genetic sequencing. Is there something like that going on in the US? And in particular, what about North Texas or at UT Southwestern?
Sequencing is actually a critical piece for tackling this pandemic and monitoring in real time for the kind of variants that we're now seeing. I oversee microbial genomics with infectious diseases, and so we have the capability here at UT Southwestern to do a lot of sequencing. And in fact, we are also starting in this endeavor to sequence virus, both from patients within our health system, as well as starting to work with the county to help them sequence more isolates than are already being sequenced in order to answer some of these questions: what variants are circulating in North Texas within the health system, to give us an idea of what we're facing as a community, what may be emerging in the near future. So these are active projects that are going on right now here at UT Southwestern.
Dr. Menachery, your lab looks at therapies for COVID-19, monoclonal antibodies, convalescent plasma, other therapies. What are you seeing in terms of how effective these therapies are against the variants of COVID-19?
In the same way that antibodies are broadly neutralized, the vaccine sera is generated against a broad neutralizing antibody response. Convalescent sera from people who have recovered, is going to be very broad and usually going to be effective against these variants widely. For monoclonal antibodies, it's a little bit different. So monoclonal antibodies are taking individual antibodies from often patients that have recovered or from vaccinated people and using that one spot. And so these are antibodies, these treatments are susceptible to these variants because they only target one location. And so if that location is where the variant has changed, some of these monoclonal antibodies will be less effective. They're often given in these cocktails that target more than one spot. And so in theory, these should still work relatively effectively. But it's something that we have to monitor with these new variants, that as they change, the location of where these antibodies target needs to be honed in on and considered when those treatments are given.
Dr. Menachery, if you had to look ahead 6 months, what do you think the pandemic will look like?
The only way out of this coronavirus outbreak is really to get to herd immunity. And herd immunity is getting to a certain percentage of people who are protected against the virus. And that's either by being infected or through the vaccine. And the question will be, if coronavirus will stay with us, will it become more of like a common cold coronavirus, and that it's something that we need to vaccinate and be prepared for, but hopefully much milder disease? And that's the hope. The other hope is that it just disappears because we're all vaccinated and all protected.
My hope is that by summer, late summer, if certainly in our country, if the vast majority of people get vaccinated, that will go a long way to ending this pandemic. Once a vaccine is available to you, you absolutely should get vaccinated. The emergence of these variants should not in any way give you pause about waiting for something different down the road. I would urge everyone to continue with the plans as the vaccine is deployed to get vaccinated. And then the second and perhaps even more important point is we need to continue doing all the things that we're doing in terms of protecting ourselves from getting the virus in the first place, from social distancing, limiting exposure, wearing a mask, hand hygiene. All of those rules continue to apply while we roll out the vaccine.
Well, I want to thank you both for joining us and for this great science that you've talked with us today about. We've been learning throughout the pandemic, and it's professionals like you who help all of us learn how we can keep ourselves safe and keep advancing our progress against this pandemic. So thanks again.
Sure. Thank you for having us.
Thank you for joining us. Until next time, stay safe and stay healthy.